Hi. So we're going to look at the two towers problem here, or I'm going to solve it, and you're welcome to look over my shoulder while I do that. So here's the problem definition. In this program, Carol should build two towers of tennis balls. Each tower should be three tennis balls high. At the end, Carol should end up on top of the second tower facing east. And then here's a picture of what that world should look like. Why am I always in the way here? If I go like this. Come on, Smith. There we go. So two towers, Carol's facing east. Hint, you'll need to write multiple functions, at least three, in order to solve this problem. And your program should start with a start function. Okay, so I'll just write function start. And we'll take it from there. Let's sort of break this down into multiple parts now. I've got a, so Carol's going to start down here, I think, right? Let's just double check. That's usually where Carol starts, yep. Look at this again. So in terms of decomposing this problem into smaller parts, I think when Carol's here, I want to move and then build tower. And then go down the tower, right? Go down tower. And then there's this sort of like two steps forward thing, and then we build another tower again. So let's call this two steps and then build tower. We can call this two steps forward. All right, so here's my top level definition of the problem, my top level design, right? And I've taken this large problem of the two towers, I've broken it down into smaller pieces. Move, build a tower, go down the tower, take two steps forward, build another tower. Now let's actually start defining what each of those smaller problems should look like. So function, we'll just start, move is already built in. I don't need to define that. Build tower, not built in. So I'm gonna need to define that. So function, build tower. And what would build tower, so this would be, assume that I've already moved once here. So build tower would be, let's turn left first and then drop a putball, right? Is it putball? Quick docs, make sure you use your functions. Oh, it doesn't show me the quick docs here that I'm looking for. So what do? I forget. There's another place I can find the docs, and that is on the, one of these tabs up here. I think I can turn off that little glowing mouse, right? Yeah. One of these tabs up here, notice there's the docs tab here. So I'm going to click that, and then I can scroll on down and see some of the built-in commands. And it is putball. Okay, so I'll go back to run code, putball. So I've already turned left, put a ball, move, put a ball. All right. Move, put ball, move, put ball, and do I have my, yeah, okay. I'll put just a couple extra returns on here so I have some space. Okay, so let's try this. I'm gonna run. Oh no, go down tower is not defined. I have a typo. So I've added in, look at this, I've added in these functions just like I'm supposed to, but I can't test my code until I've defined all the functions. That can be kind of annoying. And so what I would suggest doing here is commenting out these lines. If you put a slash slash in front of them, I'm gonna click reset to make that yellow line go away. You'll notice they change color. If I put a slash slash in front, that means the computer's not gonna run that line of code. So I can slash slash in front of everything that I don't want the computer to run. I'm just gonna sort of save it for later. So right now, the start function is those two, and then these three have been commented out, which means they're not gonna run. Now I can run the code and test that without having to worry about the fact that I haven't defined these other ones yet. So reset run, and build tower is looking okay. All right, but I wanna be able to use this build tower function again for the second tower. So I wanna end sort of how I expect to end after building this last tower. So after I put that last ball, I'm going to move once more to get on top of the tower. And then I wanna turn right So I'm going to type turn right, but remember that's not one of the built-in commands. So if I run that, speed this up. Carol doesn't know how to turn right. Hint, Carol can turn left. Of course, I knew that already. So can I make that go away? No. Okay. So I'm going to define turn right. Function turn right. It would be handy to be able to use this. And that's turn left 3 times. If you don't like to type, copy. Whoop. The computer broke. Okay, here we go. You can feel free, of course, to just copy paste. Just get these indents right though, because it looks a little messy if the indents are all off. Okay, so now I'm going to run again. Good. So Carol is where that's sort of what I would consider as the end of build a tower. So now let's define go down the tower. So I'm going to just define, come down here, define another function. Boy, the computer seems to be freezing. I'm not sure if you noticed that or not. Okay. So function go down tower. So this is going to involve another turn right, right? So when you're doing Carol, by the way, you should be doing a lot of this sort of thing. It's like yoga. So I'm going to do a turn right and then move 3 times to get to the bottom. Once I've moved 3 times, I should be down the bottom, and then I'm going to turn left. So let's test this out. Frozen again. Hope this isn't too much of a pain for you to watch. Okay, good. So run again, up and down, nice. I'm gonna just make it like that speed. Yeah, good. Turn right, and I go down, good. All right, so my go down tower works well. 2 steps forward. So 2 steps forward. This could be something like move, right? Let's run this to test it. Up, down, 2 steps forward, good. And I'm ready to build, I'm in position to build the tower again, right? And hopefully now that this second tower ends where Carol is supposed to end according to the assignment. Good. So I'm gonna click this test check code button to see my test cases, yep. And they're all green. That's a good place to be. I can click submit and continue. And good luck coding on your own.